Today, we're going to dive into Coda's new Alpha AI. We're going to uncover what it does, how it works, and a little bit more about how it compares to existing solutions on the market like Notion, Mem, and Craft. Let's dive into it in today's video. So, hello folks, welcome to Keep Productive. If you're brand new, my name is Francesco, and I'm very excited to be diving into many of the productivity tools. Let's dive into Coda AI. Now, Coda isn't the first to AI. They actually did a good job initially. They launched something called the OpenAI integration, and they weaved it into their formulas, which is really cool. It's like a nice addition. Essentially, what you could do previously is weave it into buttons. So you could, for example, have it auto-generate something for you. Well, they've been working on something in the background that goes a step further, and I really like it because it really targets what Catalog is trying to do in the market, which I've talked about here on the channel, about generatively creating structure in your documents, which I really like. So essentially, this new Coda AI, very simply in its alpha version, summarizes meeting notes, transcripts, quickly prepares you for calls, and also does stackable content in terms of a solution builder. So let's have a little look at a few examples of how that works. Now, initially, it works like many of the others, write me this. You know, what we'd expect to see in stuff like Mem, Craft, and Notion. But they've got a feature that allows you to generate tables. So you can see here that they said the prompt was, very simply, AI blog post ideas, generate the table, and you can start to see the structure being formatted. Here it goes a step further with what they're calling a system that basically takes a segment that you've already created in that table, or it's created for you, and allows you to go a step further. So write a blog post about these blog post titles. And as you can see, it goes much further in terms of detail. So that's quite a cool example, I think, of what it can do. And the same here, like here, for example, you can generate a column with what city the address is in. A really nice addition there, saving you a bit of time. And finally, here's a good example of how it's generative in terms of creating a table in the top 10 pharma companies, and then you can add the CIOs of the company added on. Really nice example, but here's where it gets a little bit more detailed. So here are some meeting notes that you may have just started typing away in. And what they'll do is you can add a column with the action items of the notes and help summarize it. But you can also go a sort of step further with these meeting notes by setting up them in a beautiful table, ready to go from day one. So it's much more organized, neat. Here's another example, a table of hotels near the Eiffel Tower ranked by TripAdvisor rating and how much they are per night. So you can start to really go deep with some of the integrations that are already inside of Coda. And what I like is that Coda packs and Coda integrations are, in my opinion, far greater in terms of structure than Notion is in how they're set up. So it's really interesting to see how this is playing out. So they're really trying to say this is AI for everything with all of the other apps integrated. So let's say you were making a meeting prep, you could generate a table with all of the accounts in Salesforce, and because the integration's set up, it automatically creates that with that integration. Another one could be, for example, let's find later on, here you go, my Gmail inbox, sort the emails by the opportunity size and give me a place to provide guidance on automatic replies. So there we go. Interesting setup in terms of how the multiple apps can link up, because that's with Gmail and Salesforce integrated. So really impressive setup here. They've got a few other examples here, like you can make a stock price builder. But can I just go back to the premise of this? Solution builder. It's building solutions for you. It's structuring what you need to build. There's not much need for a template anymore there, because it can build the template for you from scratch, which is a really nice thing that in my opinion, Catalog introduced to the market. And obviously a lot of teams have really seen the benefit of that. But where Coda comes in is the ability integrations packs. That all comes in and allows you to do a lot further with some integrations that you've got set up. So a really interesting solution for teams, saving time. Look like Shashir, who's their founder, has said that you know, like they've been using it for a while and the potential's really interesting. You see here, like he's using it, summarizing meeting notes every time. So it's a really interesting take. I definitely have to sit down with Shashir because I initially said that Coda was doing quite well with their structure of AI, with that OpenAI integration. So that's where I think Notion will lead with buttons. I think properties will become Notion's killer feature with AI. But going back to Coda, it's currently only available through this waitlist. So as you can imagine, early days for it still to be fully available. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed today's feature. I look forward to sharing more about AI productivity technologies. If you're interested, we've got loads of them. You can find them more on Toolfinder, and also just keep subscribed to the channel because there's going to be plenty more. It's keeping me busy, and I'm sure it's keeping you busy. So thank you very much, folks, and I look forward to seeing you in a future Keep Productive video. Cheerio.